Hi everybody! This is the second part of the movie about my tailbait project, where we make the hardbait front. If you haven't seen the first part yet, where we make the tail, you could consider following the link up here and watch that one first. Anyway, at this point we have a softbait tail and we want to make a hardbait front. And the hardbait front should look something like this. And I really must admit, I love this design, and I hope I'll be able to reproduce it just like the drawing. Just hang in here and see how well I manage. This movie will cover making the master itself, making a mold from that master, casting a few baits, painting and coating, and in the end, hopefully, we'll be able to go on some test fishing and show that the bait actually works. Apart from being just wicked looking, there's a few thoughts behind this design. First of all, the front eye is positioned quite high on the head to ensure some jig head-like advantages. This should make me able to fish the bait all the way to the boat side when I'm out fishing in my boat. Also, there's an option of having an embedded single hook which will make me able to fish quite close to the bottom without getting snagged or get the hook filled with weeds. And when fishing in more pelagic waters, there's an eye at the belly to attach a treble. And in the end, we'll have a corkscrew to mount the tail. Like with many of my other projects, I'll be using Super Sculpey to make the master. Super Sculpey is a polymer clay that you bake in the oven to make hard. And even though you baked it and it's quite hard, you can still cut it with a knife or sand it with sanding paper to make those final details. Making a master like this is quite time consuming, so I'll only be leaving a few clips of my progress for you to see. Been playing around with the Sculpey for quite a while. I now am as close as I can get before I bake the bait here. I don't know if I nailed it exactly like it is on the drawing, but at least I'm close enough to either have a nice result or maybe I can just give some of the finer details a touch up after it has been in the oven. As you can see, it fits fairly well the size of the tail. At least it will be fine enough for this part. I might shape it a bit after it has been in the oven, but generally I think it looks very nice in size. I won't add the eyes and the eye for the hook until later, and the same goes for the corkscrew, but I will add the hook, or at least a part of a hook, as I won't be able to put that in without maybe damaging the bait afterwards. So I think I'll just add that. being baked in the oven and having quite a lot of time to cool down, the headpiece is now ready to move on. As you can see, it's quite hard, and it will be easy to sand and shape with the sanding paper and with my knife. When I look at it and compare it to my drawing, I must admit that it ended up a little larger and a little more bulky than I actually intended. So when I'm shaving and touching up on all the details, I will also try to reduce it a little bit in size, if possible, to get it looking a little bit more like the drawing and not feeling so bulky. But let's see how it works out. I will just be going on now. As you can see, I've already removed the hook. It was easy to just pull out. That is to make it more easy for me to sand and shape, and I can always stick it back in there and just glue it on. Okay, so I'll just be going on with this, and once again, it's something that takes a while, so I'll just leave in a few clips of me sanding and shaping, but apart from that, you'll see the result in a little while. I've been sanding and cutting away for quite a while, and I'm getting closer to the result. At least I have a result now where the part that meets the tail is the same size, more or less, so that part fits. Also, I've shaved off a bit and worked a bit on all the details, so it's looking much better now. Unfortunately, along the way, I have made a few dents that are too big for just sanding, so I'll have to use a little bit of spackle in a few spots here before I go and give it the very smooth surface of the fine sanding paper. But at least I think we're getting a bit closer now to the result, and
I like it.
The master is now nice and smooth, and I've given all the details a bit of a touch-up. I'm fairly certain that it's very hard for you to see the details on this one with all the coloration that is here, but you'll see that later on when we get the first cast. Now I just need to do the final details, and that includes putting back the hook, setting two eyes, and also leaving a hole here for the corkscrew. Okay, and I'll just start by putting this one in, just for the looks, actually, because I need to put in some glue as well. I think this will be more or less how it should be. Okay, and I need to figure out where to put the hook. I don't have any lines on this giving me a center line, and it probably isn't even. I'll just have to see if I can give my best guess to where the center is and where the eye should be. I don't think it will matter that much once once you fish the lure, as it doesn't really have anything that will require very high precision. So I'll just try to place it somewhere between the eyes here, which is there, and according to my drawing, it should be somewhere like here. So I'll have to make a hole here for that eye, and I'll also have an eye down here, which should be the opposite position of the hook. And in between the fins, I think, only a little bit in, like that. So now I have a center here for the corkscrew. I have a across here for the belly eye. I have one up here for the head eye, and I have the hook. So now I just need to make two eyes for the front and for the belly. So I'll just use my plier here to do that. Okay, now we have two eyes there, and as I don't want to bother drilling the hole every time and figure out where the center is, I'll just put in a piece of wire here of a thicker dimension, which I will then pull out every time I've made a cast, leaving just the hole for me to grab one of my holders from my lure drying system to hang it in. And that will make it fairly easy for me to paint it and everything. So I'll just, for that part, I'll just need a piece of the thick wire here, which is, in this case, 1.6 millimeters. Now I just need to glue everything together, so it's nice and firm, and then I'm ready to actually make the mold. The time has come to make a mold for the head, and as you probably see me do that a lot of times, I'll only be leaving in a few clips of that. Ready, I'll just calculate the whatever I need and mix it up, pour in. Now hardened for a day, and it's quite hard, so I have taken it out of the Lego frame, and will now try to have a look at the result. And let's just split it open here. I haven't been that good with the Vaseline, I see.
Okay, I'll just have to grab a knife and cut through the rest here. There's a few spots where my Vaseline wasn't well enough applied, I see. So, okay. And, well, looks quite fine, I think. The mold is actually more or less ready to go ahead and cast some lures now, but I need to make a few preparations first. First of all, I need to determine at least at what point the head will be floating and at what point it will be sinking. And to do that, I will have to first make the internal wire that goes inside, and also make some corkscrews to go in the rear of it. Once I have those two parts, I can cast a blank without any weight in it, and then put it in a water tank, and that way attach some weights to it, and that way determine at what point it is weightless in the water. That will give me an idea on how much I should put in it, and at what point that would work. Okay. And for the internal wire of the lure, I have made this sketch of how it's supposed to be bent, going down directly from the head into the body, and then going on the length straight through the whole body, being bent a bit down to the belly eye. And the reason for this shape is that I would want to be able to attach the weight that should be mostly in the head, I think, to this wire. So when I place it in my mold, it will be in the correct position. Apart from making the internal wire, I also need to make the corkscrews. I'll do that as well. To bend the wire for the lure, I have taken a piece of plywood here, and I will be drilling some holes and putting some pins in to bend the wire over. Okay. To make the corkscrew, I will be using a tool that I picked up from another YouTuber, Mel Lures. I will leave a link up here for that one. It's just very nice and very easy to use, and it will give you a corkscrew that is the same every time. So I'll just use that. I only have a small modification, and I'll show you that in a second.
Like that.
Okay, this will be the eye that goes into the lure, and this will be a pin that goes into my tail. Okay, and I'll just place this one in my tool here, and I'll take a small brass pipe I have, which I have cut a slice into, and I'll push this over the eye here and into the holder. This should lock the wire in place, and then I'll just use the tool to bend the wire, making sure that it turns the right way, like that, and then just turn away until it snaps out of the holder, and then I'll probably have to use my plier to get the brass pipe up, like that. Okay, and then I have a compressed corkscrew here, and I'll just use the pliers to pull that out, extend it to the wished size and length. Then I can just cut it off to the size I need, like that. Maybe needs a bit of trimming, but in all, it will be a nice corkscrew for the rear of the lure.
Okay, I've just lubricated the mold with a bit of Vaseline,
I have taken a jig hook and bent it into a shape that will fit inside the mold. Also, I've taken my wire here, I just modified it a bit to fit a little bit better, as it was kind of struggling with the hook for the space here. Like that. Okay, and now I've placed all the parts inside the mold, and I'll just assemble it using the sides from another mold for this one. The first cast is now ready to be demolded, and I'm very anxious to see how the outcome is. So let's see. Well, looks quite fine. All are where it's supposed to be. Quite nice. I'll just take a small saw and my knife and clean this cast up so it's more or less how it should be when finished, and then I'll replace the pin by a corkscrew, and then I'm ready to do a bit of weigh-in here. Well, I don't actually have a need to know exactly how much weight the bait will carry before it starts sinking, but it is very nice for me to know at what point it will be sinking and floating. I will probably never use this floating, but at least still I would like to know at what point it is. So look now, well, as you can see, it floats quite high, so no doubt about that. And I'll just use these small weights here to stick onto the lure with a bit of tape, and then I'll figure out at what point the lure starts sinking, and I'll use the scale to measure it out in the end. Okay, so I'll just grab some tape here. And also this will give me an idea of where to place the weight, as I would like to have it somewhat like a jig, going a bit head first down when you let it go. Okay, so start with this, and we'll put it in. Okay, still floating, quite high actually. I think it needs quite some weight, this lure. Okay, that was just the point where it starts sinking. 9.2 grams, so 9.3. 9.2 grams would be the sinking point. Yes. Okay, now it's time to make some internal wires, attach some weights, and then I'll cast a few lures, so I'm ready to paint them and test them. I think I'll test them first, just to be sure. Okay, here for a start, I'll just start by using a lead sheet to make the weight, and that's because it's so easy to cut and shape here for the first time, until I have a better idea of how much weight is needed and how it should be positioned. So for now, I'll just cut this out into some nice pieces, and I'll make two testers. I'll make one that has 5 grams above the sinking weight, and one that has 10 grams, and then I'll go to a pond and test that.
Okay, now I'll just peel the second of the weighted ones out of the mold here. It's looking quite fine. And I'll just take out the pin and like that. Cut out the funnel. Bit of trimming.
Well, it's time to paint some of the head pieces, and I have made four pieces, two different weights, some that are weighted with 10 grams above the floating point and some that are weighted with 5 grams. These pieces have already been primed, and I even given them a pearlized white belly as, well, it's hard to see when I do it anyway, so I won't be including that on film. So those are ready. The pattern I'll be painting is at least for two of them the round Goby pattern. In some sort, there's not as much room on these to paint it, so in some way something like that. And the other two will be a darker version with a little bit of more gold, but still a white belly. And for the same purpose, I have some tails here, which is with some gold and white and completely golden. Some baits, some tails I think will suit those patterns well. Okay, I haven't made a lot of stencils this time. From some aluminum foil I have made some holes that matches the fins of the Goby here, and also I've made some small pieces of the mesh I use for scale pattern. Okay, so I'll be using this and that, and I'll just think that will be it. Okay, I'll just get on with the painting, and I'll leave in a few clips as this will not be one of those painting tutorials. Okay, let's get going. Now all four baits are done, and although it's fairly simple patterns, I think they're looking very nice, and at least this one, these colors, I know is very effective in the brackish waters, so I'll be looking forward to testing them all. First of all, they need to have a day or two to let the paint dry thoroughly. And then I'll put on some ice and give them a few coats of epoxy, and then we are ready to go testing.
front piece of the lure has now had three layers of epoxy and is ready to be fished with. Just a few adjustments missing. The two of them that was already tested for the tail's movement have their corkscrew mounted in the rear, but the two others, well, I have to peel off the skewer here and drill a little larger hole than this one and attach the corkscrews to that, so I'll be able to set the tail on those. Well, I'll just do that in a second. Apart from that, I already made some tails in different colors to be used with these. These are just standard one color bait tails, and I also used a bit of the softbait paint to paint some simple patterns on some other ones here to see if that has any effect. At least it has effect on the fisher more than the fish, I think, but we'll try those as well. Well, I'll just use some 5-minute epoxy to attach the corkscrews, and then we're going test fishing, because today is the first day after the preservation of the brackish pikes, and I'm very anxious to get these ones tested, so I'll just do this and then it's off to the brackish waters. We're out here in the brackish waters to do a bit of test fishing today. Actually, I have quite a lot of the baits with me today, but the most important thing to get tested is the Wicked Goby, my tail bait, which comes with a soft bait tail and a hard bait head, and with the opportunity of fishing and just with the single hook on top or with a treble on the belly. I don't think I'll add the treble on the belly until I actually have quite a lot of strikes that I don't get. Well, already in the harbor, I took a few casts. As you can see from this clip, I actually managed to catch a fish. Hey everybody, I just fished for 5 minutes and I already had the first take on one of the wicked little gobies here. Not a big fish, but still okay. Let's see if I can get it here. Completely swallowed the goby. As you can see, all the way down to the throat here. And as it only has one single, I hope I can release it fairly simple. Like that. And this was the color for that one. I don't think it's a big fish. Let's just measure it for good fun. 72 centimeters or something, but still very nice to have some action. And the new bait, 5 minutes of fishing, not that bad. Well, there's a lots of boats here. The sun is shining, there's not much wind. I think it would be a difficult day out here in the brackish waters, but well, there's nothing you can do but keep trying and see, especially when we get closer to the evening, if there's a few pikes here. So, well, let's get going and see if we can catch some pikes. Although I tried really hard all day, I haven't caught another pike on the Wicked Goby. To say the truth, the conditions today are terrible. It's high sun, it's no wind, and the temperature is just about 25 degrees, which is very uncommon for this season. So I think that the pike simply don't want to eat anything today. Apart from that, the fact that we did manage to catch a fish and even have a few strikes and followers on the lure proved to me that the design will work. Also, the movement in the water is just fantastic. So I'm quite sure that in time, this bait will catch me a lot of fish. Well, that is all for this time.
I do hope you liked my two-part movie about the wicked goby, and if so, please remember to subscribe to my channel. Apart from that, there's nothing much to say, but I hope you see me soon.